I remember starting my first job. The front-end engineer proudly presented to me the state-of-the-art deployment sequence he was using. 6 different terminals open next to each other, running a script he wrote, SSHing into the servers and replacing 6 different application files in production from his laptop. If you're horrified, you're in good company. I remember it was like my first day after training and I knew this was bad. So I started working. Back then, Jenkins was all the rage. 10 years have passed and I still wake up at night worried I'll have to use Jenkins again or migrate front-end scripts. Today, we have GitHub Actions, GitLab CI, and wonderful other options. But I found one that's not only created for deployment, it automates everything. It can be your IFTTT server, it can integrate with your smart home, Google Docs, heck, I made it even speak to OpenAI. But it gets better. This thing is completely open source, and today I'm not only going to show you how to get it running in 20 seconds, I'll also show you how to use premium features for free. Now, cards on the table, this video is sponsored by the project, but again, it's open source and can be used for completely free. When I started this channel, I called it DevOps Toolbox, thinking exactly of projects like the one I'm showing today. Open source, widely adopted, easy to use, and solves a problem in various ways. So I wasn't paid to say any of these things, and there are some downsides which we'll go through, but I was made aware of the project by the company behind it, so keep that in mind. With that out of the way, let's look at Kestra, the one platform that can do it all. Like I mentioned, Kestra is an open source system, over 17,000 stars on GitHub, and is adopted and praised by a large community. The main concept, at least as I see it, is orchestrate anything. If you want it, Kestra can plug it in. It's super versatile too, so it can be your CI server or integrate with your CI. It can be your Airflow, taking any kind of task and distributing it and orchestrating too. Additionally, because of its huge plugin library, it serves as an incredibly powerful open source IFTTT, if this, then that server. You know, the service that lets you plug anything to everything by rules of if this happened, then do that. The plugins are separated to categories, and if you try to casually scroll through, you've got over 200 plugins to go through. It really integrates with anything. Kestra defines itself as a workflow automation platform that can automate, scale, run anywhere, while also being language agnostic. If you had the pleasure of maintaining Groovy scripts, this one is especially important. Just to show you how easy it is to get up and running, let's run it locally. A simple Docker run, mapping the default port 8080. Since Kestra is, well, an orchestrator, it needs to run Docker in Docker. To those of you who hadn't done this before, that's why mounting the Docker socket from the host is required and also considered a common practice. We then add the /temp directory for some persistency and one Java flag unique to macOS so that the JVM doesn't lose its head, but you shouldn't worry about that. That's it. 3 seconds later and we're up. When you first launch Kestra, it offers a friendly guide helping you pick the model that works for you. Super thoughtful. Let's start off with a simple hello world just to see a sequence running. There's a progress bar for each step and step with timelines and logs. Once completed, we can expand each to see what happened, which would be especially relevant when things fail. Now, as you can see, the mounted Docker socket was relevant since every step is a container, pulled remotely. In this instance, it's Ubuntu. It runs, performs the tasks, and shuts down. There are a bunch of other tabs and information, but I want to jump straight into the code. If you edit the flow, it shows up on a simple YAML, holding some metadata and an array of tasks. If these tasks require some user input, it can be described on top as well. And while other alternatives makes the next feature incredibly complicated, to automate a certain task with a simple cron, all you need is a cron trigger added. As you can imagine, there's almost an infinite list of available triggers, and we'll see a few in action. Now, let's make some changes, like the default user string. This default, as the name suggests, can be kept or overridden externally by the user as well as other properties below, like labels and schedule. However, what I found far more appealing than that is the fact that each flow can be remotely triggered with a simple curl command. How brilliant is that? Let's run it once with the changes to see everything completes as expected. And moving over to the terminal, we'll try a remote trigger. Kestra is still running up here, so let's keep the logs visible and shoot the command, changing some of the data to indicate it's coming from the terminal. Now, a few interesting bits here. One, the logs above record the execution, that's expected. But also, calling the curl command returns a JSON with everything we need. This is incredible for automation and such a clever way to help DevOps engineers and just people who like automation and consistency. You send your command from practically anywhere, even your phone. The response can be easily parsed and read with a local UI to log what happened. The options are really endless, but enough with me getting all excited over a JSON return to the CLI. Now, the execution is obviously recorded in the UI too, so it's time for the two killer libraries Kestra offers. The first is the Blueprint Catalog, essentially a list of pre-baked pipelines for anything you can think of, from cloud deployments through server configuration management to running on changes in Google Sheets. If you want to go a level deeper, the plugin catalog opens a sea of options. I mean, come on, look at this. Over 200 options for triggers, inputs, data manipulations, cloud platforms and databases. Look at it, BigQuery, Elastic, specific AWS commands, or the entire CLI. If you don't find your super niche requirement, you can always write your own custom bash script or Python or Go or any language you like. It's all running in Docker containers, which makes essentially everything a plugin. Yes, Kubernetes fans, there are a bunch of plugins for you as well, so you can actually create a pod in a cluster as a response to a trigger. If you think about it, this can kind of become your own autoscaler inside a cluster. That's how flexible this system is. But if I asked you what's the biggest bubble, most hype thing currently, and probably we've ever seen, you'd all have one answer. AI. Yeah, even OpenAI gets a plugin, a bunch of them, really. So we can chat with the model or even generate images, and we're going to do exactly that. Let's create a flow and copy the plugin's details and try to generate from Kestra a bear hacker wearing an orange jumper in front of his laptop. I don't know where I got this idea from, but while we're at it, maybe it's time to print it on a t-shirt. But there's our first problem. At some point in your journey, you're going to have to use secrets here, whether to communicate with external systems, the cloud, or like we need right now, AI platforms. And for whatever reason, Kestra keeps these under a strict and vars only for non-premium users that cannot use the UI. Gotta pay the bills, right? I don't have a lot of complaints, but this is definitely one. I wish they kept other features behind a paywall, but then again, paying the bills and all that, plus it's open source, so you know, you can fork it and work your way around. However, we're not left with absolutely zero options here. Here's how to overcome this and make your life so much easier with one simple change. Stopping the service here, as it is running on a standalone container, which will translate to Compose. I'll leave a link below to the Compose file should you want it, but any free LLM will translate your Docker run command for free. So with Kestra, tucked in a Compose service, I can easily set up environment variables. Prefixing them with secret and underscore will take the key into secret context, keeping the value safe and encrypted. Just keep in mind the value has to be base64 encoded for this to work properly. And there we have it. Running again shows open API key in the secrets list. So it's time to inject them securely into the flow by referencing a secret with OpenAI key surrounded by a couple of curly brackets and quotes. Okay, time to run. The task succeeded and outputs can be conveniently downloaded using the UI. And holy shit. That's terrible. Yeah, full screen only makes it even worse. What can be interesting here is combining this flow into something that's useful. So what if I'd switch this prompt into a user changeable input, then trigger it remotely from a shell command? So I'll do just that and create a DevOps engineer installing a Windows server, which I'm sure is going to be an improvement from the last run. Let it run and yes, oh my god, this is so much worse, it's actually funny. I can't even read what it says. Wimgo, we adopter, is it pulsing vibe? Okay, so before concluding, I do want to plug an output integration to show off the versatility and send it to my phone. My choice is often Telegram, which is super convenient and API oriented, so that's what I'm going with. Another downside some of you will quickly find, and that might not all be on the project, although they can help with it, but if you take any LLM, and I mean any, Claude, ChatGPT, Gemini, it doesn't even matter how smart the model is, for whatever reason, if they try to produce Kestra's YAMLs, they always get it wrong. And I mean always, but not in a way that seems to be a complete hallucination, but rather a model trained on all documentation. In comes my idea for Kestra. Build an MCP around your syntax and at least for your most popular plugins so that users can easily produce pipelines instead of fighting with plugin configurations that often change. Hi, it's me from the future. I actually got Kestra to comment on this, and what do you know, they actually do have an MCP, which you can happily use to create whatever pipeline you want. They just smashed my one suggestion, but we can automate just by using prompts. Happy days. So it's important to stress that you don't have to use code. Kestra comes with a no-code editor that lets you fill in the form instead, which is kind of nice. I'll use a channel ID and a token. Pro tip, if you're on Telegram, there are two services you want to be familiar with. One is Botfather, which creates Telegram bots, generating tokens you can work with. And the other is Group Info Bot that, once added to a group chat, spits out the system ID and then leaves the group, both useful for this step. Switching to no-code shows the same view from earlier with the values in YAML, so we can now run. Now the send to Telegram step failed, but I did get a message on my phone, so I'll call it a win. The log tells me it's something with how the plugin parses the response, and I'm not going to debug Kestra's plugins. I'm happy with it as is. The dashboard now shows success versus failures, whether anything's in progress, and an overall great TV screen page to show if this is using the company's brain or just as a HomeLab core automation system. So you can automate pretty much anything now, maybe even deploy your system remotely. But are you sure you're using the right system for production? Most people tend to choose these based on FOMO or hearsay. So I want to introduce a perfect system to deploy your remote containers. And you may be surprised to hear you already have it installed right now on your machine. Check out the next video about Docker Swarm. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.